everyone. Welcome to today, lesson 4, which we're going to talk about two fruit of the Spirit, which is patience and kindness. I suppose you have obviously gone through the previous lesson on love and joy that we talked about, and hope that you have obviously gained something out of that. And the Holy Spirit is continually working in your life and in our lives, really, to allow Him to do what He does best. All right, so today we are on lesson 4, fruit of the Spirit, patience and kindness. As an introduction, let us go through what patience is and also what kindness and goodness is, okay? So patience, on your notes, it says, is a virtue that is developed or developmental in nature. It is the key to inheriting the spiritual blessings of God because it upholds faith. In Hebrews chapter 10, verse 36, okay? So the issue of patience deals with attitudes and actions in our responses and not so much the feelings. So you've got to get that. It's very important that it's your response to a situation, and it's actually more than your feelings. Okay, I'm not sure whether you've ever come across this analogy. Someone said, you know, they prayed a prayer. They said, God, give me patience and I want it now. You know, so that's really not the ideal way of praying. Okay, so when you say, God, I want to develop patience in my life, and it will take adversities, it will take times of testing to allow patience to be developed. So let's move to the next one, which is kindness and goodness. What does it actually mean? So the Greek word kindness carries the idea of usefulness. When somebody is being kind or showing kindness, that is so true. They are actually attributing or giving you something that is going to be beneficial. It's going to be useful. Later on, the concept of moral excellence was added, so it became one of the main words in Greek, which denotes goodness. That's why we have kindness and goodness. A person who has this kind of goodness will show kindness to everyone. See that how it all both ties together. So when you have the goodness, you will show kindness. This type of kindness, okay, flows from moral excellence that also reflects the idea of uprightness. Real uprightness and true goodness is expressed in active kindness to others. And I'm sure most of us are aware that it's a thing that goes around the world where it says it's a kindness day or something, you know, where you show kindness to people. When you show kindness, there's got to be what? An element of goodness, obviously, and uprightness, okay? So that you can show that. In Titus 3, verse 4, when the kindness and the love of God, our Savior, appeared, it says, He saved us. So that scripture confirms the kindness and the love that came from God. So when He actually showed that to us, what happens? It became something, obviously, that is useful for us to adopt, useful for us in return then to practice kindness and goodness as a result of what God has given to us. Okay, let's look at some characteristics of patience. It is, point A, an unswerving commitment to persevere in spite of difficult or discouraging circumstances. How many of you would have, at some point in your life, encounter some difficult situation where you're just thinking, oh, I just don't know what else to do? And in that time, most of the situation is patience has to be applied. Because if you try to obviously rush things, it may not be to your best outcome. So the element or the degree of patience is really needed in those circumstances. It is an unswerving commitment, all right, to persevere. Yeah. Point B, it is an expression of hope and trust in God. That's what patience is. You see, it's having that hope and having that trust in God and saying, God, I don't have the answer, but I need to be patient. Patience is one of the hardest things to really grab a hold of, but yet it is so much needed in each and every one of us. Point C, it is a God-like active concern for the well-being of others. That is a good one. Okay, it is a God-like active concern. So when situations obviously didn't work out the way we thought it is, or when somebody did something or mistreated us, so we need to have that God-like active concern to have that patience. Point D, it is a character trait of God that can be translated to us to become a way of life. It is a character trait of God. The Bible says God is patience. He is long-suffering. Okay, so really it's one of those things that needs to be translated into becoming a part of our day-to-day living. So patience is needed in many situations. Point E, it is produced during times of tribulation. Romans 5, verse 3 and 4. Or it is during times of testing. The testing of your faith produce perseverance and patience. Notice that, okay, in James chapter 1, verse 3. So really, if you ever prayed, say, God, give me more patience, you've got to be prepared to go through more testing. Because it is always during those times that you would allow that patience to develop. Let's look at some characteristics of kindness. Point A, true kindness. What is true kindness? It has its roots in patience of the Holy Spirit. True kindness has its root in patience, but got to be through the Holy Spirit. It will never or neither intentionally or unintentionally cause pain to others. Okay? That is a characteristic of kindness. So it's not intentional or unintentional. But when it comes to showing kindness to others, this is irregardless of what has happened or what they have done to you. You want to continue to show the kindness that comes from the fruit of the Holy Spirit. It is a sweetness of temper which puts people at ease. Oh, that is a good one. Have you ever been with people that when you look at them, they don't, in a sense, they don't get angry easily. But in situation, they're always showing a certain temperament that is putting you at ease. You know that you're okay when you're with them. There's no thing as, oh, he's going to blow up, okay? Or she's going to blow up due to this situation or due to this matter that has occurred. So it is a sweetness of temper, okay? And point number four, another characteristic of kindness, it costs something to be kind. Example, sufferings and sacrifices of Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9. So it costs something to be kind. So you want to be kind to somebody? It will cost you. Jesus went through sufferings, obviously, and sacrifices to show us the kindness of God, to show us the sweet temper of God. All right? Point number five, it calls for a certain quality of toughness within ourselves. It entails courage, integrity, and selflessness. That's what kindness involves. Okay, it's not so much about us, but it's more about others. It's about having the courage to even go beyond, okay? But that you are not living your life based on the fear that grips you, but rather the courage and the integrity to go forward. And also it says there is a certain quality of toughness. Oh, yes, when those things go tough, you got to keep going. Not easy, but the characteristics of kindness is always moving forward. Point number six, it comes through our being connected to a merciful, compassionate, and kind God. In John 15, verse 5, that when you are connected to the vine, the Bible says, what happens? You begin to show or bear the fruit. That's why the Bible talks so much in John about bearing fruit, the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Because when you're connected to the vine, you ought to be bearing fruit and fruit that will last. Okay, let's look at the second part of what we call counterfeit kindness. There is such a thing as counterfeit kindness. Number one, soft is outward sentimental indulgences. Okay, so it's about just the outward appearance, showing an outward appearance, but really deep within is not genuine. Okay, and it's all got to do with self. I'm going to do this to you so that you can then do something back to me or repay my kindness. Well, that is not true kindness, is it? When somebody does something to you without expecting any return, now that is true kindness. That is a character trait of God. That He did this, He saved us, He showed kindness and mercy without expecting anything back from us. Because the Bible says Christ loved us while we were yet sinners. All right? So another counterfeit of kindness is what? It's a tolerance or compromise of wrongs and evil. Okay? So that is another counterfeit element of kindness. So what happens? You begin to compromise, okay, in the wrongs and the evil of things. So that is not true kindness. Let's look at point number three, the characteristics of goodness. We have mentioned about the characteristics of patience, the characteristics of kindness, and let's look at the characteristics of goodness. What does it entail? Okay, point A, this is the nature of goodness. It is a character that is both virtuous and kind. That's good, because when you have goodness coming out of your heart, the goodness of your heart will what? Show both kindness and patience and being virtuous as well. It is the expression which demonstrates to another that he or she is important. Now, I want to use an example of goodness. When I was working in Singapore, this is just an example just to illustrate this point. I remember often I would receive phone calls just from members of the worship ministry that would ring me. And if I'm not there, what I would tell my secretary at that time, and I would say to her to take the name of the person who tried to reach me, but I'm not in, make sure you get their name and tell them that I will return their call. Okay? So instead of saying, oh, I know Pastor Ray is not in, can you please call back later? So I said, no, don't do that. Can you please get their name and their phone number? Because the very fact that they try to reach me tells me they're wanting to talk to me about something. So the important aspect is actually on them, not so much on me. So I would say, get their number so that I can ring them when I'm back in the office. Can you see that? So that's an aspect of showing the goodness of who God is. Okay? So it's an expression which demonstrates to another that he or she is important. Point number three, it demonstrates graciousness towards one another by doing deeds of goodness to enrich others. That is a characteristic of goodness. When was the last time that you did something that would help to enrich the life of someone else? When was the last time? Perhaps to make a call, perhaps to send a gift, perhaps to send a card, whatever it may be, that you would have done something to help enrich the life of someone else. So that is goodness, okay? Real goodness is always God-likeness. Matthew 19, verse 17. Real goodness always reflects the image always display the goodness and the likeness of God. When people say, oh, you know, you're good, but the reality, the Bible says no one is good except God. So whenever you show goodness in any measure, what you're doing, you are displaying an aspect of who God is. Think about that for a moment, how important it is to be showing goodness. When you show it, you are displaying something of who the nature of God is. And that shows, and that becomes a blessing to someone, and that helps to enrich the life of somebody, okay? And number five, it is true giving from the heart. That's what goodness is. That's a characteristic of goodness. It's actually showing the true giving from the heart. Like we said earlier, it's not just an outward thing, but it's an inward thing that is coming from you inwardly, displaying and showing, okay, without a sense of expectation to be repaid. So I want to show you goodness because I want to display who God is to you. All right? So that was point A about the nature of goodness. Point B, it says only God is good, as I mentioned earlier in Mark chapter 10, verse 18. He does good to all mankind. We know that. Only God is good. He gives good gifts to those who ask in Matthew 7, 11. So the Bible says, ask the Father and He will not withhold any good gift to His children. Okay? And next, point C, God's evaluation of goodness. What does it mean from God's perspective? What does this, how does He view goodness in your life as a fruit of the Holy Spirit? Point number one, choosing to be in communion with God is good. You see? So from God's perspective, this is what goodness is, that we are, that we choose, okay? It's a choice that we are making now to be in communion with God. To God, that is good. That is a good thing. That is an aspect of goodness. Mary chose the good part in Luke chapter 10, verse 42. You know the passage when it talks, you know, about Martha and Mary. And Martha was the one that was busy preparing everything, all the food and everything. But Mary went and sat at the feet of Jesus, learning from Him. And then, you know the story, Jesus says, for Mary has chosen the good part. That is to what? In communion with Jesus. Point number two, being obedient and faithful to the Master is good. Matthew 25, verse 21, when Jesus talked about the parable of the talents, okay? Jesus says to the one who multiplied, says, you good and faithful servant. To God, being obedient to what He says is good. See that? So He calls the servant good and faithful servant. And point number three, being useful and beneficial to others is good from God's perspective. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10 says, you are created for every good work. So to be involved in doing things, to be involved in serving others, to be involved in enriching other people's lives, from God's point of view, those are good things. That's why He says, thou good and faithful servant. Mary has chosen the good part and it will not be taken away from her. And you are created for every good work. All right? So let's have a look at what the application, how do we apply this in our lives? Most of us know what it means to be a patient person. We all know it. But what about being kind? What does it mean to be a kind person? How can you be kind this week to your family, to your colleagues, to people that you know, that you talk to or you journey with? Okay, think about that. Ponder for a moment and think of a kind act you could do this week. Write it down on a piece of paper, then fold the paper such that It can be placed in your wallet, maybe your purse, and it will serve as a reminder this week for you, okay? Only after you have done the act, then you can take that note out, okay, and give it away. So this is an application about being kind and being good, to display an aspect of goodness in your life. So this week, can I encourage you, even as you have gone through the lesson or you'll be going through the lesson, let's practice, okay? Patience is something that you need to develop over times of testing. And I can tell you that if you feel that you haven't been tested, well, you just wait. You will be, okay? And none of us would say that we haven't, all right? But to develop that patience and perseverance, God will allow us to go through just times of testing. It is a good thing. It's not a bad thing, because it keeps our dependency and reliance on God. The kindness and goodness, what an incredible fruit of the Holy Spirit that we can display, because it reflects who God is. So may you be blessed this week as you go through this lesson. And I pray that you will really get something out of this study as you allow the Holy Spirit now to work in your life to display who God is. God bless you. Have a great week.